Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you the easiest way to get started with Final Cut Pro. I'm going to be breaking this down into a few easy steps so you can follow along using the chapter markers below. That way you can rewind or fast forward to the bits that you need to rewatch. So if you haven't done already, head over to apple.com via your web browser and download your free trial copy of Final Cut Pro. This way you can get through today's video and see whether it's something that you feel is going to up your game in video making. So the computer I'm using for this tutorial is a Mac Mini and it's running OS version 12.1. This is a M1 Silicon Mini Mac with 8 GB of RAM and a 500 GB hard drive. What we need to do now is locate your copy of Final Cut on your Mac. So if you head down to your dock and click on Launchpad, go to the search bar and start typing Final Cut. It will pop up here and what you want to do is click on that, left click, and drag it down to your dock. And that will put it down there so you can quickly access it. Now, click on that icon. Final Cut will boot up. As you could see then, as it was booting up, I'm using version 10.6.1. That's as of the 25th of February, 2022. So here we are inside Final Cut, finally. And this is the layout. So I'm not going to really go through any technical details as such, only other than this is where your library is going to be. This will be where your footage is. This will be where you see your playback. This is your inspector over here. And this is your timeline down here. So what we need to do now is import some footage. So before we import some footage, we need to create a desktop folder to put your project and your footage into. So what I'm going to do is go to File, New, Library. What I need you to do is create a new folder. I'm going to call this Project 1. Click Create. So then you need to name your library. So I'm just going to name my library Project 1. Click Save. And there we have our first library. Now what we need to do is import some footage. So very simple. Go to the Import Media. So make sure in Favorites here you've got Desktop highlighted. And also here you need to click on Desktop. That's if that's where your footage is. So click on Camera Footage. And that will select all the footage inside that folder. So you don't need to open it up and select things individually. What we now need to do is create a new event. So if you go up here to the right, create a new event name, and I'm going to call this Bar Italia Car. You'll see why in a minute. For me, I select Copy to Library because I want a self-contained project. That way, everything's within one folder, and if you move it around between hard drives, you're not going to lose any of your footage. So leave Copy to Library checked, leave all these how they are, and click Import All, ensuring that your folder on your desktop or SD card is highlighted. Click Import Selected. So here we have all of our clips. So they've all come into Final Cut. We can scrub through them here. And if you scroll down, you'll see all your clips in a row here. Now we need to create our first project. What I need you to do is hold down Command, click A, and it will select all of these clips. Right click on the first clip and click New Project. Name your project. Final Cut will automatically recognize the footage you're importing. If it comes up with anything else, just click on Use Automatic Settings. You might be importing footage that's being shot in portrait from your phone. You might be importing square footage. You might be importing 4K or HD. But if you do it this way, Final Cut will automatically select the settings based on your clips. So we don't need to worry about anything else here. Click OK. So now you've created your first project and you have all your clips in the timeline. If you use your mouse or trackpad, you can just scrub through, looking at all the clips. Very straightforward. And if you want to increase or decrease your timeline, you use the Command plus or minus key. And wherever your playhead is, it will centralize when you zoom in on that. For now, I'm going to expand our timeline just a little bit so we can start our edit. Okay, with the clips in the timeline, you can now start scrubbing through and selecting the parts that you want to keep. So if you bring the playhead to the beginning of that clip and press the space bar, it will start playing that clip. What we're going to do now is just select those portions of the video that you want to retain for your edit. So I quite like this after it's tilted down. So from about here, hit space to stop. What I want to do is delete this part of the edit. Now there's various ways to do that. You can either grab that with a left click and drag it, or even quicker, you can use Option left bracket and it will delete that back. I find that a much easier solution. Then you want to find the other end of the clip where you want it to end. Probably about here. So then we go Option right bracket and that deletes that. So let's go back to the beginning, press play by pressing the space bar. Now what I've noticed on this first clip is because it's handheld, the camera does have a stabilizer on it, but it's a little bit shaky. So you can eliminate some of that shake by scrolling down in the inspector panel with your clip selected and click on stabilization. Final Cut will go ahead and analyze your clip. It will punch in just a little bit. It will zoom in a tiny bit just so it takes that shake out. Then if you go back to the beginning of your clip, press space. And you can see already that that's much smoother. So I think we should probably end that clip there. So Option right bracket. Moving on to our next clip. Do the same. So we don't need a tilt down. I quite like it when that guy walks behind the car. So there. Option left bracket. And then there. Option right bracket. Next clip. Don't need that clip. So you can highlight it, press the delete key, and it will disappear. I don't think we need this clip either. Delete. I quite like this shot, and I would like it from just pushing in, so probably about here. Option, left bracket. And then just before the camera moves, I reckon Option right bracket there. This is our next shot. Playing it through, I think I want to start the clip from here. It's quite a nice reveal of the inside of the car. And then just as the camera zooms out, I think we'll end the shot. I quite like the shot of the guy taking pictures on his phone, but we don't need the end of the shot because I somehow managed to film my foot. So let's end the shot. Takes a picture, end the shot here. Next shot, quite like this walking through the people. So I want to start the shot here. Option left bracket, and then ending the shot here, I reckon. I'll just leave it to the end. So first shot, space to play. Nice and steady. In fact, we don't need that shot to last any longer than that. Option right bracket. Space to play. As soon as that guy appears, stop with the space bar. Option right bracket. Space to play. There's great. Option right bracket. option right bracket, then play this clip, spacebar. Now, this last clip is a little bit too long for my liking, so what I want to do is just cut a chunk out of the middle. So to do that, we want to start the shot there like that. So what I want you to do now is hold down Command and click the B key, and that will blade. So it's B for blade. Move your playhead to where you then want to cut. Option left bracket, and it will delete it back to where you use the blade tool. So now what you've got is a little bit of what's called a jump cut. So that shot doesn't have to last as long. So let's just have a little look through this and see if anything else needs stabilizing. I think that last clip could do with a little bit of stabilizing. So again, select the clip, scroll down, click on stabilizer or stabilization, and it will automatically analyze, and it should look a little bit smoother. Yep, really nice. Now, as you've noticed, I don't have any sound on these clips. Your clips will probably have sound, but I'm not going to go over that in this tutorial. I will cover that in a future tutorial. But for now, this is just about editing and getting you to be able to export your edit. Essentially, that is your edit complete. Obviously, you could refine it a little bit more, and depending on what you shot and how many clips you have, it might take a little bit longer, it might be a bit quicker. But you are now ready to export your footage and all your clips. So this is really simple. All I need you to do is go up here to this box on the right hand corner and click on YouTube and Facebook. Now this has some predefined resolutions it can export at. And if you click on resolution, you can see them all here. Simply what I need you to do is just click next. Don't need you to do anything other than click next. And then save. This will be saved to your desktop or anywhere else you choose to save, but just for ease, let's save it to the desktop. So now what you'll get is a little timer up here, and this is your background tasks of the render taking place. So once the shot's finished exporting, you should get a prompt in the top right hand corner that tells you your clip has been exported and is ready to view. Now you can head over to your desktop and view the clip you've exported. Just double click on it to preview and playback. There you have it, is your first edit all exported. So that concludes today's tutorial, and I hope you found it useful. If you did, please hit that like button, please consider subscribing, and please ring that bell if you'd like to be notified of any future videos. Now, I'm interested to hear from you whether you did find this useful, and if there are any other parts of Final Cut you're unsure about and you'd like me to cover in future videos, and I'll be happy to make them where possible. I thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye for now.